Everybody, it's Invicta, and we did it. You all did it, Mosh Pit. We have hit 60 on the like streak counter, as to be expected. Thank you all very much, sincerely, for the 60 days of hitting the like streak goals. I really appreciate it. It helps out the channel so much, and I am looking forward to getting to the eye tracker episode this Wednesday, so make sure you stay tuned for that. And of course, if you're not subscribed already, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you get notified when the newest videos go live here every single day. Thank you all very much, Mosh Pit. We've got ourselves another Eden run, and we have ourselves an amazing artwork slash meme of the day brought to you by 357 Patch. Battle thread was Sinvicta and Sissy cards. Now, I will say that I think that this is a work in progress from Patch, and I believe that on the Reddit thread they were asking for ideas for the effects as far as the tapping effects for Sissy, or like the effects or damage or rolls that Sinvicta, the character card, needed on the right-hand side. So if you have them, post them down below. Let 357 Patch know on Reddit, or just go to the Reddit thread and post them there for yourself. And thank you very much, Patch. It's coming along great, and it looks freaking awesome, man. I would love to see those in like a PSA grade or something. That'd actually be like the highest honor, to get like a graded card that was like made for me. It's freaking awesome. Oh boy, same day is going to be Kilo 9 Whiskey Quebec, Whiskey Juliet, Victor Papa. So it's April Fool's Day, and fools on us, because we've got ourselves a just god-awful, and I mean god-awful start. Like, one of the worst possible starts you can... I mean, this isn't a trifecta of bad, y'all. This is a quad of bad. We've got 0.89 movement speed. We've got 2.04 tiers, 2.74 damage, and 0.77 shot speed. Yeesh. Now, you may have noticed me sort of manipulating the Vist that we have back here with Friend Finder, because that's basically the only damage that we have for this entire run. And on top of all that, to make things worse, we have only 1 HP. So, yeah, we're already at crisis levels of bad, everyone. I don't know what else to say. We are in crisis mode already. And I don't want to seem like I'm over exaggerating or anything like that, but like, seriously, it's that bad. I know it's going to do a super jump. I'm just waiting for it. I'm trying to bait it into jumping. That was way too close to death right there. Way too close to death. I'm trying to bait it into jumping into the brimstone shot from our Vis and Friend Finder. Man, oh man, this is... Oh boy, this is rough. Now, obviously, if we get ourselves a way to get the sharp key, or if we just get a bomb, we can get that tinted rock. Yeah, that cap doesn't really do anything for us. No cap. And this is basically going to have to be nothing but the Vis for us. We have to take this soul heart here. It is not even a question. Normally, I would be like, yeah, you know, this is fine. Like, you know, it's kind of whatever. You know, we can deal with the first floor headaches and then save the soul heart for the devil deal. No, mate. This is way, way, way worse. Now, thankfully, we were able to absolutely raffle dunk Ragman here. I don't even know what raffle dunk means. We're just gonna go with that. We end up getting the Gaper back anyway. Yeah, so at least we got ourselves the tears up, so it's a start, but woof. This is a rough start here, y'all. So I'm gonna try to time the Vis here along with the with us going through the wall, door. So we can make sure that we get the brimstone shot right off the bat. Yes, I am kind of ticked that we lost our charge here. So yeah, so I'm gonna pre-charge the Vis and then just have him just fire the brimstone shot. Now you're noticing that sometimes the brimstone shot actually fires downward, and that's because I'm trying to fire with Isaac, and the Vis will always fire in the direction that Isaac is firing. So what you're seeing here so far, this strategy is working fairly well for us. We have a golden bomb, so we can use the golden bomb to get into, hopefully, what will be the secret door. Secret room, I should say. Gonna wait for the Vis to recharge here. Oh, baby. Yeah, this is going well so far. I mean, despite our many our many shortcomings at the start of this run here. Gotta be careful of the fires. I don't want to accidentally just nuke all of our friend buddies here. As you see here, the bomb does not actually hurt the Gaper. We're gonna wait till I fire, then pre-fire, go into the room, and then try to manipulate the mobs to come after us going through the brimstone beam. And so far we're doing a good job of it, but this is just an example of us using our knowledge from all the experience that we have in Isaac and basically making the most of it. And I think if you understand, oh, we got ourselves a dark bony. If you understand how to do this, then these kind of starts can be made very, very, they can be turned into something a lot less threatening. I am going to check to see the Devil Deal just in case if we get something like Sinvicta Robes that would allow us to take a Devil Deal without actually killing us. So we can actually take both of these. I'm going to take Dark Prince's Crown first, and then we can take the Sinvicta Robes to get back to 3 HP. So there's basically just... I mean, that Devil Deal was free. It was literally free. Just kind of searching for the Super Secret Room, which I don't think is actually in here. It's not in here. So shout out to Friend Finder so far anyway for absolutely being a Giga Chad spacebar item and getting us through. But honestly, like we gotta kind of pat ourselves on the back a little bit as well for knowing how to use the item properly and also recognizing the types of attack patterns that we can use and mobility that we need in order to make the most out of our vis. It really comes down to the multi-directional vis here that really helps us out. Unfortunately, we cannot get into the store, so I mean, that's just the cost of doing business. But hey, you know what? We're alive. We got ourselves some damage. We got ourselves some tears. And no longer are we totally dependent on Friend Finder for damage. But that being said, though, we cannot take it easy. I want to make sure that we don't hit these barrels. Yo, we did take one hit of damage in here, so we have 2.5 hearts left. Bad, I don't want to blow up our abyss. There we go. I don't care about the Isaac heads. What's really going to be bad here is going to be the Dark Bony blowing up next to our abyss, so hoping that doesn't happen. For the Vista to charge up again, then we go through. There we go, like that. Get ourselves Gigante Bean. Don't really need it right now. We also don't need to go in and do that mob trap room. But look at this. We have all the dark chargers in here, and Friend Finder really, really showing the value that you get out of it. If you can keep your friends safe, make good decisions on positioning and whatnot, you can get a lot of value out of Friend Finder. And as you saw on that first floor, Friend Finder was the reason why we didn't die on that first floor. I hate to sound a little sensationalist, but it is true. Friend Finder is extremely, extremely helpful when it comes to when it comes to softening the blow of a bad start. Now we did lose the Dark Bony, and that's okay. Man, Glowing Hourglass is pretty good here. The Glowing Hourglass will allow us to keep the Vis alive for quite a long time. And also, of course, undo any bad damage that we take. Now, we are sacrificing Friend Finder here, which is, don't get it twisted, this is kind of a gamble here. But I think having the ability to undo bad damage, we can also take pills if we really wanted to. So if we really, really, really wanted to, we could take this. Pheromones doesn't really matter. We can also check for secret room. Super secret room. Okay, so we get that. Get our bombs, okay. Blue Chub is pretty tough. Look at that. The Vis still alive, still kicking. get another tiers up and a shot speed up. So again, we're making headway. We're really chunking down these stats and making them a little bit more respectful. And 2020 is going to help us out a lot as well. I got to say, it's pretty impressive how fast we were able to recover from just a nightmarish start. We want to try to keep everyone safe here. So we're committing to the glowing hourglass, which honestly I think is a good idea. It just prevents us from taking bad damage and having it be permanent. And if we somehow lose the Vis, it gives us this weird opportunity to keep it alive and actually prioritize it over some other things I might not have. Careful. Lose some of our chargers, that's okay. As long as we didn't lose the Vis. Let's try that again. Okay, well, they just walked into the spikes anyway, so whatever. Oh my goodness. This just absolutely nuked Pin and Larry. Wow. Yeah, that was worth it. We get another tiers up. So all of a sudden, we find ourselves almost with a fully upgraded tier stat. That is remarkable how fast we turned around our horrible tiers up, our tier stat and shot speed. Now all we really need is honestly just damage. I mean, damage would be huge for us to recover. Trying to take a stab at a soul heart here. Oh. We don't have to go that way, I won't. I don't want to lose the Vis. This is bad. Oh, he's still alive. You know what? We can just not go in there, that's fine. I said that was weird because, like, we have this weird sort of responsibility to try to keep our Vis alive. I'm gonna do it. Like, we've already beaten the boss. Look at that. Trying to keep him alive. This is the most MVP of any Vis that we've ever seen from Friend Finder. I mean, literally carried us through four floors. That's value right there. That's big time plays right there. I wish I could undo that, but I can't. Just looking for the... I know that the game's going to force us to go through that other room. I just know it. I see it happening. Going to make us go through that other dang room. We're going to lose our Vis to get to the item room in the store. There it goes. So the greatest Vis that ever was... Officially, I'm going to say, since it did clear the fourth floor boss for us, I'm going to say officially that this hard carried, and I mean hard carried us through four floors without dying, up until its death, I should say. And that is remarkable value out of Friend Finder. I've never seen a Vis more MVP than that. After making one big Isaac circle here, we are finally going to go find our item room. Of course, 2020 did give us the damage down because that's just how the new 2020 works, and they felt that was something that the game needed. I'll make the rules here. But it does... I mean, 2020 is still kind of good. The fact that you can... It's still 2020. Like, the damage down sucks. It does. Was the damage down, was it necessary? I'm going to say no, it wasn't. But, again, I don't make the balance decisions. But for what it is, 2020 is still a pretty good item. And Curse the Blind. So, at least with the glowing hourglass here, Curse of Blind, the effect of Curse of Blind is somewhat lessened, only because we don't have to worry about taking the blind item. We can just simply undo it if it's really, like, wow, Terra bad. So I am going to go here and check it, and it's going to be belly button. And we get monkey paw. Monkey paw is fine. It'll save us from death, so... No, it's like a, it's basically like a temporary scapular that will always proc. And very rarely do we ever have to see Monkey Paw being utilized. But it has happened on occasion. In Repentance, we've seen Monkey Paw actually proc and save our life. So we still have only 3.55 damage, just barely better than base Isaac damage. Which is pretty doo-doo, but, you know... For what we started with, it's remarkable that we have a very good chance at making boss rush. I'm not going to use the Satanic Bible yet. I think that would be foolish. We don't want to lose our boss item. We don't want to pay HP for a boss item or Devil Deal item, especially with it being Curse the Blind. Even though I just got done saying how we can lessen the impact of Curse the Blind a little bit because of the Glowing Hourglass, that doesn't mean that I actually want to force myself into doing so if I don't have to right now. And we don't particularly need the HP. We're not on death's door or anything like that, so. Of course it is April Fool's Day. What's the big one that the internet is abuzz about? I remember back in the day when the Blizzard April Fool's pranks or jokes or posts were always the rage of the town. Are they still doing it? Have they done it yet? Obviously this wasn't recorded on April 1st, so I don't know for sure. I think Devolver Digital also used to do them as well. I swore that I heard a heart drop, but apparently not. All those meme companies, you know. I'm not sure if people expected an April Fool's or anything like that today from me, but I don't usually partake in the April Fool's. You know, it's usually harmless fun, but at the end of the day, it's, you know, I don't want people to, like, to be fooled by something. Like, you know how stuff gets taken on the internet. Like, you all know. You've been on the internet long enough to know. And if you haven't yet, then no, you sweet summer child. I don't want to start a tradition of being like, oh, hey, look, we just got, like Hextuple Brimstone, the new item in Isaac. Whoa, you know. I think that'd be not very becoming the channel. Stopwatch we will take. Definitely will take here because we want the movement speed upgrade. Movement speed and damage are now the only two things that are really holding us back from a miraculous turnaround. We are kind of running out of time though in terms of our boss rush timer. So we have to make sure we have at least one charge on the Glowing Hourglass to make up for Curse the Blind here for our Devil Deal if we do get one. Ideally, if we are going to get a Devil Deal here, I hope it's Krampus. So we don't have to guess. And Stopwatch being a big help here, not only slowing down the rest of the game, but also speeding Isaac up. Consolation Prize, which is going to mercifully give us a damage upgrade, and we get Lord of the Pit, which is going to give us flying and movement speed, so that Curse of Blind wasn't too bad. I forgot to use the Satanic Bible. And another Curse of the Blind, this time on our boss rush. So now we require basically all three of our charges to go into boss rush. Should we decide to take a boss rush item to compensate for Curse the Blind, again, this one's obviously way more annoying because not only do we have to compensate for that, but we also now have to worry about our Devil Deal, and prioritizing the Devil Deal for the over the boss rush is difficult. Get ourselves a Stars card, so we now just have clear reign to, or free reign to go straight to the boss rush. We would have to go the correct way, which is Not this way. This is ultra pride. I am going to take the left hand, because I feel like the game owes us some devil deals. This Curse of the Blind crap. Even that little tiny 0.8 damage upgrade that we got from Consolation Prize, it makes such a difference here. With us firing multiple shots with 20-20, despite the damage down, we're still going to be causing more damage per second. That's the whole big deal about that. The Consolation Prize, big time plays. Don't care about the shop right now, and we have gone absolutely every wrong way to go, except for the right way on our way to boss rush. All right. Here we go. How does he do it? There we have a nice healthy volley of shots that we can just plow right into any target in front of us. And stopwatch really, really helps us out because that allows us to kind of group up the mobs like in this room here and then just let them all detonate. Wondering why I didn't go into the item room, it's because we have a stars card, so we might as well save the keys. We're already very low on keys despite just getting a golden key here. It's beside the point. There we go. Get ourselves a soul heart. And let's go fight Mom. Seemed like Red Mom for a second there. Her foot was coming down real quick. I think that taking the glowing hourglass was absolutely the correct choice over taking Friend Finder, despite how hard Friend Finder carried us in the early going here. The glowing hourglass undoing damage and allowing us to take blind items and pills, that sort of thing is almost invaluable, especially if the game's going to be in a trolling mood and give us back-to-back Curse of Blinds. So we get to lessen the blow of that a little bit, but again, it's still... doesn't make any less than annoying. I'm going to take the negative here for stats only. And here we go. So, all right, well, that's Mega Bean. There's Tammy's head. So it's two space for items so far. Good. And Scorpio. I will settle on Scorpio. We get Psyfly as well. Could I have taken that last item there? Yes, I could have, but in case we needed to undo a bad purchase, we could. It's no offense to Spider Mod, but I think we can do better. Usually the claw machines pay out with something pretty good. There you go. That would be better. No offense to Spider Mod guy. But it is what it is. We end up getting Jacob's Ladder with 20-20. That is phenomenal. And our comeback is almost complete. We just need to get better damage at this point. Another curse, this time Curse of the Unknown, so slightly less annoying than Curse the Blind. But you know, it's just sometimes Isaac matches, or sometimes Isaac runs like boxing matches. There's the metaphor. You know, at the beginning they had us down early. We got rocked, we got stunned a little bit, we lost our legs out from under us. You know, double vision was, we were kind of weak, we're not exactly sure. We weren't prepared for the onslaught, and then all of a sudden, stuck with it, didn't give up, didn't get negative, didn't get down on ourselves. Next thing you know, we're back in this fight, and now we're poised to actually make a huge comeback. Give the game a knockout blow. Super Envy here, which is going to be no match for 2020. Jacob's Ladder, just showing you how versatile Jacob's Ladder can make 2020, despite us having not phenomenal damage here. Still great. Could we take this pill? Yes, we could. I'm not going to right now because we may need to undo some damage later on, which is going to be way, way, way more valuable of a charge on Glowing Hourglass than simply undoing one pill that we just didn't have to take. Psyfly doing some work here as well. By the way, when I said stats, I'm for the negative, I was talking about the damage up that we get taking it. In case if you were curious as to how our damage went up. Look at that, we're able to basically fully assault Blastocyst there before he even got a chance to really attack anything. Get meat. And give us our Dark Prince's Crown, which is going to give us a Broken Tears raid. Now we can go back and take the pill without fear of terribleness. Okay. I don't mind that one that makes you small is not the end of the world. We can deal with it. Okay. We already went in the curse room. That's where the charge... No. Yeah. That's where the charge came from. All right. Dark Prince's Crown is going to give us a huge tears up as well as a little bit of a damage up as... Yeah, we'll take perfection, even though we probably won't be able to hold on to it. That's not me being negative. That's me simply just being real. I mean, we're not going to hold on to perfection. Like, we're going to lose it. It's just a matter of, it's not a matter of if, but when. I try to explore all the types of scenarios for everybody. You know, whether they be good or bad, I try to give you a list of options, you know? I think it's important not only to point out the good scenarios, but also the bad ones. You can't have bad without good, and you can't have good without bad. Light and dark, all that kind of stuff. Ooh, I saw that quick shot. I saw that eye laser winding up. Definitely feels like the correct way to go. Yeah, and right there, that's a great example. Something I've spoken about in the past before, getting some damage on the game before it even knows that you're in the room. That is a very important aspect of the stopwatch. And it can make your life a lot easier. Even if you don't have great stats, even if you don't have amazing tier effects or anything like that, like Jacob's Ladder, you can still take advantage of the game just sitting there waiting before the AI kicks in and starts going after you. You can actually take out a lot of really easy enemies before the room even activates fully. So Bloody Gust and Sister Maggie. I don't actually want either one of these. Mainly because I think I'm happy with our Dark Prince's Crown buff. I'm not planning on taking any damage and losing perfection. And in order for us to get any sort of value out of Bloody Gust, we would have to take damage. So it's not exactly in the cards. And yes, we'd be able to undo them, obviously, with the Glowing Hourglass, but that's beside the point. We only have three charges, and holding onto those charges may be more valuable than saving perfection and trying to hold on to a Bloody Gust, you know, full charge or something like that. I don't value it as much right now. Scorpio doing damage. Honestly, shout out to Scorpio for making some pretty big time plays here as well. Damage over time cannot be discounted. Not want to pick up the heart. If we picked up that heart, we would have lost the Dark Prince's Crown buff. Sidefly is going to make this fight a lot easier here. We don't have to worry about the little side swipe shots from Stanley. Then what we want to do is we want to start. I like to start in the top left-hand corner. It's easier to see where the where the shadows are coming from the feet. Also gives you maximum amount of room to move around in. You just go on the perimeter of the room. Perfect Satan fight. Another Curse of Darkness. Not that big of a deal, but still a little bit annoying. Yuppie's Eye. Damocles. Damocles is totally worthless for us right now. I do want Guppy's Eye, but not until we get a red heart on the ground. And the reason why is because that red heart that we have is going to go away if we take Guppy's Eye. I'm going to actually drop the left hand for now. The main reason being we don't necessarily want red chests currently. Even though they could be a good source of soul hearts and maybe even a devil deal teleport, right now we want a little bit more items. Jacob's Ladder taking out all the sides here from death, making it a lot easier for us. No big deal at all. Rubber Cement's fantastic with Jacob's Ladder. Now all we need is we just need one red heart now, or a half heart, to get us the Dark Prince's Crown buff. Dark Prince's Crown buff is what I meant. No, we do not want anti-grav. See all the rubber cement tears now bouncing all over the place. I don't know where Sci-Fly was on that. I was watching him. Kind of absent on that one, Sci-Fly. Sack. Leprosy. And the wrong end. Get Quince. Quince is good.
The fool.
All right. Now that we've been to that side of the chest, now let's go to the real side. We're just never going to be content with us not losing that bone heart. We still take Guppy's Eye, but now we wait until we get to Lamb. The red heart, one room too late, unfortunately. And that is the way. All right. All right. So there you go, everybody. There's the entirety of the map. Now we can enjoy the long trip back over the right side of the map. Let's go see the lamb, shall we? How does he do it? If you ever wanted to see the effects of doing a full clear and how it negatively impacts your runs, look at this floor. That's why I always harp on how important mapping is. People like to make fun of me for it, and I don't really care. Knowing where you need to go and knowing where you need to not go will keep you safer than you getting lost and doing full clears any day of the week. Is a staple in safety when it comes to Isaac. Knowing where you need to go, knowing where you haven't been, all that stuff, it matters, trust me. All right. So we're going to nerf our damage. Take the Eye of Guppy for a Guppy item. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use the stopwatch after we split the lamb. It's going to take us a little bit because our DPS is now pretty bad. Wanted to shoot Little Brimstone that way. There we go. Perfect lamb fight. Very nice. It's the beginning of the month, you know, and it's also Saturday. Let's do it. Whippy Axe 48. Do the smart way, shall we? Let's not just blow up this entire room, get hit, and then be like, oh, we could have just hit the button. A little bit limited on keys here, so we... What in the world? I mean... Okay. Alright. Well, there's 2020 again. We'll take the blanket for the Holy Mantle. Holy Mantle effect inside of boss rooms is very nice. And we also get ourselves a nice little soul heart to go along with the purchase of one blanket. Secret room should be to the left of here. The spike tried to dupe me there for a second. Of course, we would love to get our HP back so we can get our Dark Prince's crown back. Instead, we're going to get some shot speed and range, or some movement speed and range, I should say. I got the curse room real quick. Nothing in there that we care about, so we're going to undo it. The glowing hourglass. Yeah, I mean, varicose veins, if you get hit, it's nice to be able to do a little bit of a retaliatory strike against something. Up close, varicose veins can do quite a lot of damage, and so can that item right there, which we will just not even talk about. I am going to take blood clot because we have triple shot here. This is the poorest of poor man's version of Inner Eye, and actually, ironically, it's a better version, the superior version of Inner Eye, because we're not hit with a massive tears down. I know. You want to see me take TM Trainer, I know. TM Trainer, quite simply, is just too dangerous to take. It is way, way, way too chaotic. Now, if we had extra lives, I would think about it. But even if we had extra lives, I still wouldn't be 100% sure, because TM Trainer can literally make you reroll by just moving. It can kill you by moving. It's not a good item. I know it's wacky. It is the epitome of wacky. I know. But if you want TM Trainer... do it on your own save file, because I'm not doing it on this one. But if you do want to see the wackiness of TM Trainer, then definitely come out to an Isaac Madness run on Twitch. We haven't done an Isaac Madness... we haven't done an Isaac Madness run... Oh, wow. Actually, that's the actual Eternal D Sizzle. We haven't done an Isaac Madness on YouTube before because there's no real good way for me to do it. Like, I mean, there are gifted subscriptions on YouTube. No, we do not want Lodestone. Thanks. There are gifted subscriptions on YouTube. But I don't know how well that system goes. And yes, I mean, comparatively speaking, like YouTube subscriptions, for all intents and purposes, do the same thing as a Twitch subscription. They let you use emotes, except only in the channel that you're watching instead of like site-wide, which makes no sense at all. If I have a Sumito YouTube membership, then I should be able to use Sam's emotes in like my chat, or I should use a Sinvicta. I should be able to use a Sinvicta emote in Sumito's chat. You know, like that's like that. That I mean, that just makes sense. That's industry standard right there. So, but that being said, I'm not opposed to coming up with ideas on how to do Isaac Madness on YouTube. It's been a long time coming. Outside of just straight donations, I mean, I'm not exactly sure how else to do it other than the gifted subs. Which, again, it's a way more elegant process over on Twitch than it is on YouTube. That is one thing that I think YouTube sorely lags behind on is the live streaming aspect and the UI and all that stuff. Not entirely sure what happened in here. We got double tapped, and I didn't even know that we got hit once, so pretty happy that we had the glowing hourglass for that. Got ourselves the belt, which is going to give us a little bit more movement speed. Remember how to turn back to Isaac. I think we just turn back on the next floor, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, I mean, if we have to do this as a loss, whatever, we'll be able to do it. I ain't worried about it because we got the glowing hourglass and we also got a great build. Yeah, we're still the lost. Oh, whatever. We may not go fight Mother anymore, but whatever. But now we're the lost. It hurts. It now does nothing. Oh, there we go. We got it back. Yeah, I was going to say, I'm pretty sure all we had to do is just pick up something. Very confused there. Eraser, we don't really need. Don't worry, I'm still gonna go. We're still gonna go alt path here. The only reason why I'm doing it this way is just because it's much, much, much easier to go through caves 2 than it is to go through Dross 1 and then, you know, Dross 2 and then go down to the mines. But now we just get put directly into mines 2. We can skip the golden buttons here because we've got flying. We can just bomb this. This does cost 2 bombs, but I think it's still worth doing. Save us a little bit of time. Now, this is going to kill our red stew buff, and that's fine. We've done a very, very good job at making a big comeback here. And look out. I mean, like, outside of our damage, we now have a little bit of a flashback to what our starting Eden stats were on this run, and, like, that is the difference. Like, it was an abysmal start, an absolutely god-awful start. And, you know, we did a good job at making the comeback here. And like I said earlier, using the fighting metaphor, we were down early and stuck with it, didn't give up, didn't get down on ourselves, didn't get negative or anything like that, and we overcame pretty big chunk of adversity there. And especially with a tier stat this bad, it really highlights how dangerous a bad tier stat can be, especially the mother run here where we have to essentially clear stuff with only our base tier stat. Trying to help future Sinvicta out here. Hey, look at that. We got ourselves a coin. Nothing's more
Nothing's more nerve-wracking than the Eternal Flies on a mother run either. There we go. No problem at all. We can go straight for the item room. Tinted rock over there. That we needed, of course. Gonna take Polyphemus, which is going to shore up that the big damage down that we the big damage that we didn't have, and now we've got big damage. So I think officially we can now say that we have overcome all the early game adversity that we had on the start of this run. We've gotten our tiers to almost capped. We've got amazing damage now. Great DPS, a good tier effect. There goes the Tough Twin. Tough Twin Larry and Creep Creep is just odd. Very, very weird. Odd boss room here. Oh, we've seen all the candles now. All right. And did that because there's no reason for us to waste all of our money there and then just not buy anything. We could, like, later on see maybe a claw machine that we might need money for. Yes, you can always use the argument of, well, we might get money equals power. That is true, you could. But you usually get a lot of money anyway, so if you want to play like that, go for it. I don't really put too much emphasis on taking every single penny that you see just because you might get money equals power. But, you know, there is some merit to that strategy. Sorry about that. I had a pressing Discord message. Not long enough to have to pause, but not short enough to get before the commercial break. Okay, we did see that there was a soul heart over here. And again, I think, honestly, shout out to Scorpio for making a lot of the lack of damage that we had early on completely trivial. Yeah, best bud, why not? Well, I guess we could fight Greed. It didn't cost us any quarter. Or any keys, I mean. We could get the quarter, but we didn't. Crawl space here as the crooked penny. And rubber cement really destroys bosses like this. Bosses that cover a large range area. We get Tropicamide, which is actually not a bad thing for us with the tier size up. Of course, the range upgrade also helps out a little bit, but the tier size up is nice because of Jacob's Ladder. Thank you, Rubber Cement. So if we need some HP there, we could definitely get it, especially if we get rid of these Red Heart containers, which we're not really trying to get rid of, but if we do, we do. Would be nice to get back to Dark Prince's Crown territory. See, they were already at 49 cents. I mean, and this would bring us all the way up to 58 cents. So, yeah. Like I said, I don't really make too much of a fuss to not about not picking up all the, like, every single coin that drops, despite there being no real reason not to, outside of just pure laziness. Because if you do end up getting money equals power, chances are you're probably going to get 99 cents anyway, so it's not a monstrous deal in my mind, but some people make it out to be. People expect you to play perfect all the time, and, you know, that's just those people. We don't care about playing perfect. We care about having fun and winning. Only thing I care about.
Judgment.
Even judgment that would take us down to the Dark Prince's crown territory. I'd take the battery just because, I mean, hell, why not at this point? Not that we can get a double charge or anything on the glowing hourglass. We can still maybe get ourselves an extra charge on the regular hourglass if we ever need it. Actually, you know what? Let's grab the bloody crown because I forgot that it also affects stuff in corpse. You know, new mama goes down. Judas is freaking shadow. I mean, we would be sacrificing a large amount of DPS for it, and I honestly don't want to. Lost soul buddy, check him out now. We've already gotten boss rush item. I mean, skinny on mushroom, it would give us a big boost in tears, but it wouldn't necessarily increase our DPS because of the damage down that it gives you. And we're already getting hit with a damage down anyway. Well, now that I think about it, I think the damage down got nerfed from skinny on mushroom. I could be wrong about that. I think I've contemplated that very thought every single time we've seen skinny on mushroom in repentance. Who knows? I don't know, man. Scorpio doing an excellent job here, just poisoning stuff. Bouncing around the euthanasia tears to try to save us a little bit of time, but this host is trying to be a jerk. There we go. I'm going to absolutely take Ouija board here. It gives us a tears up. It gives us spectral tears. Very good for rubber cement and Jacob's ladder as well. Really, the biggest danger to us, honestly, is just making sure we don't pick up a red heart. As dumb as that may seem, holding on to Dark Prince's crown is pretty important for our DPS at this point. So important, in fact, I would say that it's actually probably worth it for us to undo picking up a heart, should we do it. And as you see here, despite even having mapping, we still go the absolute wrong way. It would not be a Sinvicta run without making sure we went absolutely every wrong way to go. Making sure we tell everyone about it. Yep, now goes Chimera. We get Jesus Juice here. And honestly, it's showing you how big getting the bloody crown is. I mean, giving us an item room in corpse, like, corpse doesn't do anything. Like, there's never any shops and every item rooms. Very rarely do you see special rooms there outside of, like, a curse room or something like that. So the fact that we get ourselves two extra item rooms is pretty huge. Now, obviously, they're not going to be that impactful because we're already pretty much set on this run. But that being said, it's still pretty nice if you were doing, like, an achievement run or something like that, or if you just wanted to go to alt path. Oh, my God. Okay. Well, I think we all know where we're going with this. Yeah, so Dark Prince's crown buff, we're probably not going to care about anymore, I'm going to be honest, because we got ourselves Sumptorium, the only item that I would have even considered giving up the glowing hourglass for against Mother. Yeah. Yeah, Sumptorium is still every bit as good as I have been saying it is for the last, I don't know how long, since we discovered just how OP this item is. It just makes everything stronger. In fact, I don't even think we need to use Sumptorium again here. Unless we lose a clot. I can't even see what's going on, to be honest. Is just an absolute obscene amount of damage that we're doing. Yeah, she's dead. We didn't even use Sumptorium against Mother, and she is dead. So there you go, everyone. Wow, what a comeback run that was. And man, I cannot believe that we have hit 60 on the like streak goal again. Thank you all very much, everybody. Stay tuned for the Eye Tracker episode. That's coming up Wednesday for Wacky Wednesday. A sincere thank you to everybody who has made this like streak goal possible, and I'm really, really happy that people are looking forward to it. I am as well. Like I said, we're going to learn a lot from the Eye Tracker episode, and thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Have a great start to your weekend, everyone. Happy April, and as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Smiler, Sam, Fred, Garrett Trimmer, Nicholas, Oi Skull, WTF, and BBQ Sauce Mix. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.